Hello everyone, I'm Balak, your educator. We are starting the weekly current affairs compilation MCQ lecture series wherein we will compile current affairs from all the important sources like The Hindu and PIB. Subscribe to Arpita Sharma classes for daily news analysis, economic MCQ series, Indian polity classes, strategy related classes for UPSC, CSE and much more. You can also join our Telegram channel for class updates and notes. Also, Arpita ma'am is taking live classes on Unacademy Plus. Use code SHARMA20 and get 10% discount. Okay, so here's the quote of the day. Happiness is not something ready-made. It comes from your own action. So work accordingly. Stay happy, stay dedicated, and I hope every one of you clears the exams. Okay, let's begin, guys. First question for the day is, consider the following. First, police is under the state list as per 7th schedule. And second, the commissioner of the police is the head of the unified police command structure. Which of the above is true? Okay, so answer here is C. Under the seventh schedule of the constitution, police is under state list. Okay, in the arrangement in the force of the district level, there is a dual system control exist. In this at district level, there is a dual system control in which superintendent of police SP has to work in coordination with district magistrate, that is DM, and in commensurate system, the commissioner of police is the head of the unified police command structure. Okay, these are the two types of system two types of arrangement for administration purpose of police works. Okay, okay, next question. Consider the following regarding carbon emulsion. First, India has committed as creating an additional carbon sink of 2.5 to 3 billion tons by 2030. And second, India has committed to reduce its emission intensity by 33% to 35% by 2030 as compared to 2005. Which of the above is true? Okay, so answer here is C. India, as a part of its contribution towards the fights against climate change globally, has committed itself of creating an additional carbon sink of 2.5 to 3 billion tons of carbon dioxide by 2030. Okay, India has also set a climate action plan called as National Determined Contribution, as per which India has to reduce the intensity of carbon emission by 33 to 35% by 2030 as compared to 2005. ओके नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वेयर इज द कार्विंग्स और स्कल्पचर ऑफ त्रिमूर्ति सदाशिव नटराज एंड योगीश्वरा फाउंड? ओके वेयर इज दिस कार्विंग्स और स्कल्पचर फाउंड? Okay, so answer here is C. The Elephanta caves are the caves where this kind of structures, carvings or sculptures are found. These caves is mainly based on two ideologies, that is Hindu and Buddhist ideology. The main orientation of main temple and other temples, relative location of other temple is such that it forms a mandala pattern. Okay, the caves is made up of solid basalt rock majorly, and the carvings narrates the Hindu mythologies with a large monolithic. It is large monolithic carvings of Trimurti, Sadashiva, Nataraja, and Yogeshwara. In this caves, Trimurti Sadashiva is Lord Shiva with three heads. You can see the picture. That's a picture of Trimurti Sadashiva. Lord Shiva, God Shiv, with three heads. Okay, Yogeshwara is a god of yoga, and Nataraj, everyone of you knows. Okay, next question. Consider the following regarding Miyawaki. First, it is a technique started by Japan, and second, it is used to grow dense plantation within a short duration. Which of the above is true? Okay, which of the above is true regarding Miyawaki? Okay, so answer here is C. Miyawaki is a Japanese technique of growing dense plantation within a short time. Okay, in a short time. The technique was started by Japanese. Considering the climate of Japan and regularly occurrence of natural calamities like earthquake, Japan is very prone to occurrence of the natural calamities. Okay, so considering that, this technique was developed so that rapid plantation and rapid trees can be grown. Under the approach, dozens of native species of same area are planted in the same area close to each other, very close to each other, such that only the top of the plant receives the sunlight, and the growth of the plant, of course, it's upwards, first upwards and then sideways. Okay, so next question, where is the Bhitarkanika National Park located? Okay, the location, where is the location of Bhitarkanika National Park? ओके सो आंसर हियर इज डी. भीतरकनिका नेशनल पार्क इज लोकेटेड इन द नॉर्थ वेस्ट केंद्रपारा डिस्ट्रिक्ट इन ओडिशा. यू कैन सी द पिक्चर इन द ईस्टर्न. इट इज द पार्ट इट इज द नेशनल पार्क लोकेटेड इन द ईस्टर्न साइड ऑफ द इंडिया. ओके इट हैज रिसेंटली डेसिग्नेटेड एज अ रामसर साइट. दे आर 10 मोर रामसर साइट डिक्लेयर इन इंडिया रिसेंटली. सो भीतरकनिका नेशनल पार्क इज वन अमंग द रामसर साइट एंड इट इज ऑल्सो बीन डेसिग्नेटेड एज सेकेंड. इट इज द सेकेंड रामसर साइट इन द ओडिशा आफ्टर चिलिका लेक. ओके फर्स्ट वॉज चिलिका लेक. ओके नाउ यू कैन सी द पिक्चर. हियर आर ऑल द नेशनल पार्क्स एंड सेंचुरी इज ऑफ ओडिशा. सो वॉट यू हैव टू डू इज ओपन यू एटलास एंड ट्राई टू फाइंड ऑल दिस नेशनल पार्क्स एंड सेंचुरी. Okay, next question. Which among the following is the latest UNESCO World Heritage Site? Okay, which among the following is the latest UNESCO World Heritage Site? Okay, so answer here is A. Jaipur, the city in Rajasthan, the pink city, has recently got the title of World Heritage Site of UNESCO during the 43rd session of World Heritage Committee held in Baku. Okay, held in Baku in Azerbaijan. Next question. With which country Caspian Sea does not share its boundary? Remember, it is does not share its boundary. Okay, so answer here is A. Caspian Sea is bounded with Kazakhstan, Russia, Azerbaijan, Iran and Turkmenistan. You can see the location: Russia, Kazakhstan, Turkmenistan, Iran and Azerbaijan. Uzbekistan is a country which shares its boundary with Kazakhstan and Turkmenistan. It doesn't share its boundary with Caspian Sea. Okay, next question. Where is the port Sabang located? Okay, what is the location of Sabang port? Okay, no guys, map related questions are high in number in this session, but it is necessary because UPSC 2 asks the map related question, and knowing the map, studying the map will also help you in your mains preparation, right? So this is how you study the map. We can't remember it by looking at the atlas every time. This is how where you interact with the map. So what is the location of Port Sabang? Okay, so answer here is B. Sabang is developed by India. It is the port in Indonesia. Okay, you can see the location where it is located. It is located in the Strait of Malacca. It is the deep sea port in the Indonesia Sabang. India has developed that port to emit the China's attempt in the region because of its Belt and Road Initiative. Because of the Belt and Road Initiative, China is trying to be dominant in that region, and to avoid that, to counter that, India has developed this port. Okay, and this is not the only port developed by India to counter the China's desire. So this port is strategically very much important in the Indo-Pacific region for India. And of course for China as well, but to counter the China's desire to be dominant, to be prominent in the region, India has to develop this port. Okay, the port, now what happened is the port will give the better access to the Southeast Asian markets. Okay, you can see the location. Strait of Malacca is the strait where we can directly go and access the Southeast market. So if the India or China, any of the country has a prominence there, it can easily boycott the Southeast region, right? If China has a prominence, China can easily boycott this region and ask the countries not to trade with Southeast Asia for increasing her own trade, right? Same India can do as well, but India's intention are not like that. So India has just created the port to counter the China's intentions, to China's desire. Okay, next question. Consider the following regarding Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. First, it is the scheme which is completely funded by center. And second, the scheme comes under MORTH, that is Ministry of Road Transport and Highway. Which of the above is true? Which of the statement is true regarding Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana? Okay, so answer it is D. The scheme, Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, the scheme was launched in 2000. It was previously completely funded by central government. But in 2015, as per 14th Finance Commission, the scheme was funded by both center and state in the ratio of 60-40. Okay, 60% from center and 40% from state. And it doesn't come under Ministry of Road, Transport and Highway, but it comes under Ministry of Rural Development. Okay, last question for the day. What is Santa Masa? I'm sorry if I pronounced it wrong, but what is Santa Masa? Okay, so answer here is C. Santa Masa is a giant gas exoplanet. Santa Masa means cloudy, a cloudy giant exoplanet. Okay, it is a cloudy giant exoplanet which orbits close to its host star. Okay, whatever the host star is, it orbits around it, the host star, and very close to the host. Generally, it takes 2.13 days to orbit the host star. Okay, and it belongs to the class of exponent known as hot Jupiter. Okay, exoplanet, not exponent. It belongs to the class of exoplanet, which are called as hot Jupiter, and the orbit is in circular motion. See the beautiful picture, how beautiful it looks. Okay guys, thank you everyone. Please write the your marks in the comment section. Like the video, share it as much as you can. Share to your friends, share to your colleagues who are preparing for their exams. And I hope every one of you liked the video. Thank you.